Russians take to the streets all over the country to protest their government's invasion of Ukraine. As this report tells us, over 4,000 people have been detained in a government crackdown on anti-war protests.
Police detained more than 4,300 people across Russia on Sunday at protests against President Vladimir Putin's invasion of Ukraine. That's according to an independent protest monitoring group, which said it had documented the detention of at least 4,366 people in 56 different cities across the country. Video obtained by Reuters showed dozens of protesters in Yekaterinburg being detained on Sunday, and one protester there was shown being beaten with a baton and kicked on the ground by police in riot gear. The video showed numerous protesters, some elderly, being escorted onto buses by security forces. Russia's Interior Ministry said earlier that police had detained around 3,500 people, including 1,700 in Moscow, 750 in St. Petersburg, and 1,061 in other cities. The Interior Ministry also said 5,200 people had taken part in the protests. Some Russian state-controlled media carried short reports about Sunday's protests, but they did not feature high in news bulletins. The last Russian protests with a similar number of arrests were in January of last year, when thousands demanded the release of opposition leader Alexei Navalny after he was arrested upon returning from Germany, where he had been recovering from being poisoned with a nerve agent. Navalny had called for anti-war protests on Sunday across Russia and the rest of the world.
Russia's aggression in Ukraine is also sparking protests around the world. Hundreds marched in Mexico City Sunday to protest Russia's invasion. Mexicans and members of the Ukrainian community marched along one of the city's main streets, calling on governments to do more to help Kyiv. Protesters also marched outside the White House demanding increased military support for the besieged nation. They're calling on the West to heed President Zelensky's request to institute a no-fly zone. The U.S. and NATO had rejected the Ukrainian leader's appeal, saying a no-fly zone would expand the war beyond Ukraine's borders. Meanwhile, anti-war protesters in London sang the Ukrainian anthem, Ukrainian national anthem, in a show of solidarity with the embattled nation. On Monday, Ukraine is set to ask the United Nations top court to issue an emergency ruling requiring Russia to stop its invasion, arguing that Moscow's justification for the attack is based on a faulty interpretation of the genocide law. Russian President Vladimir Putin previously said his, quote, special military action is needed to protect people who have been subjected to bullying and genocide, a claim Ukraine has been denying. The case lodged at the World Court, or the International Court of Justice, centers on the interpretation of a 1948 treaty on the prevention of genocide signed by both countries. The treaty names the ICJ as the forum for resolving disputes between the signatories. Meantime, Pope Francis is rejecting Russia's assertions that it is carrying out a special military operation in Ukraine. The Pope says that Moscow's attack is war, plain and simple. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky urges Western nations to put more pressure on Russia to end their invasion. But for Russian President Vladimir Putin, there is only one way for the fighting to end. We have more from this report.
Russian President Vladimir Putin on Sunday said his campaign in Ukraine was going according to plan and would not end until Kyiv stopped fighting. His remarks were made in a phone call with Turkish President Tayyip Erdogan, who appealed for a ceasefire in the conflict, as did French President Emmanuel Macron, who held a nearly two-hour phone call with Putin on Sunday. Nearly 1.5 million people have fled in what the UN calls the fastest-growing refugee crisis in Europe since World War II. Efforts to evacuate some of the 400,000 residents from the heavily bombarded city of Mariupol failed for a second day on Sunday. The Ukrainian coastal city has endured days of shelling, trapping people without heat, power and water. Kyiv has renewed its appeal to the West to toughen sanctions, and Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky asked again on Sunday for a no-fly zone to be introduced for all Russian rockets.
If you don't do it, if you do not provide us with at least planes so that we can defend ourselves, then there is only one conclusion to make. You also want us to be killed very slowly.
He added that Russia was preparing to bombard another southern city, Odessa. Washington and its NATO allies have resisted Ukraine's appeals for a no-fly zone for fear that it would escalate the conflict beyond Ukraine's borders. U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken on Sunday said that the U.S. had seen very credible reports of deliberate attacks on civilians, and that Washington was documenting these reports to support potential war crimes investigations. Russia denies attacking civilian areas. The West has ratcheted up sanctions and scaled up efforts to rearm Ukraine, sending in items ranging from Stinger missiles to anti-tank weapons.
Thousands continue to cross the border between Ukraine and Poland to escape violence. Taking part in the humanitarian mission at one of the border exits is Filipino Jaime Tan Paklibar, who works for the Zambian embassy. Paklibar says many are stranded at the border because of a shortage of buses. He says that the refugees that arrive are both cold and hungry.
Bumayag naman kasi yun, humanitarian naman ang gagawin ko. Kahit hindi naman nila kalahi o kaya ano, siyempre pag pag nakita kong, sabi ko, pag may Pilipino, tutulungan ko rin. Yung mga nakita ko sila, yung mga bata, parang maluha-luha sila nung salubungin namin. Kasi kuminsan, halos dalawa, tatlong araw sila naglalakad. Eh ang problema dito, sobrang lamig.
The Department of Foreign Affairs says that so far, over 100 Filipinos have been evacuated from Ukraine. Among the latest to arrive here in Manila are 6 Filipino adults, 4 Filipino-Ukrainian children, and their Ukrainian mothers. They arrived in separate groups over the weekend. Another group consisting of 3 Filipinos from Kiev have also departed for Manila. In other news, Philippine presidential bet Vice President Lenny Robredo deplores Russia's invasion of Ukraine, echoing the position of the Philippine government at the United Nations General Assembly last week, contradicting President Duterte's current neutral stand on the conflict. Robredo says it's a moral imperative to speak out against bullying and unprovoked aggression, especially as innocent lives are being affected.
Ginagawa natin ito hindi lang bilang isang prinsipyo, pero bilang din pagsalubong do sa ating interes. Kasi gusto natin na kung sakali namang tayo ang gaganyanin, di ba? Tayo ang lalabagin ng ating karapatan o soberanya ng ibang bansa, titindig yung ibang bansa kasama natin.
The International Atomic Energy Agency expresses concern over the developments at Europe's largest nuclear plant. Ukrainian authorities say Russian forces seized control of the plant Friday after setting an adjacent training facility on fire. They are said to have placed staff running the facility under their command, restricting their communications with the outside world. The UN nuclear watchdog is also concerned about another Ukrainian site seized by Russia, the spent fuel and radioactive waste facilities at Chernobyl.
I think it's imperative that we have a framework, and this is why I am prepared to come to Ukraine as soon as possible. This has a number of elements that need to be considered. I am in active consideration of those with the two interested parties, but yes, of course, we are following this permanently.